3, 2, 1. Hello, my friends, my little YouTube friends. Welcome back to my channel, you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for all your love and support. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I cannot thank you guys enough for allowing me to have this platform that I have today. And today is a very, very special video because it's very near and dear to my heart, and I've went through a lot the past year and currently, and I feel like the past month and a half is where I've made my leaps and I'm back to feeling like how I used to. And I think a lot of you guys have noticed that too. Comment down below if you guys have noticed how I feel. So one good news that I received was the mass was removed out of my ovary. I got cleared. Now, that doesn't mean I'm cleared for the rest of my life. I have to get checked every 3 months, but I am cancer free. I know I posted that way later than I should, but like, you guys have to understand, I cope with things differently, just like how you guys cope with something. I can't post in real time when I'm going through something unless like I'm okay. When I posted about it, I got a lot of weird backlash. I remember, actually, I don't get triggered by people in their comments. I posted a photo and somebody commented, "Is this what ovarian cancer looks like?" And it really triggered me deeply, very, very, very deeply. And I stopped talking about it completely after that, just because I found it extremely insensitive on another level, like bullying. And you never know what somebody is going through unless you've walked a mile in their shoes. So like, people don't know the hardships I go through. I don't know the hardships you go through. I don't know the amount of things that you guys have to deal with, what your family life looks like, who you're looking out for. Neither do you guys about my life. So I just think if I'm sharing something so sensitive with you guys, I would hope people have the common decency to be kind with such sensitive information, but they were not. Therefore, I just stopped talking about it. But thank you, Dr. Tyus Alibadi. I'm cleared. I'm fine. Don't worry about me. I'm fine, in the words of Kanye West. Today, we are going to talk about BetterHelp. Thank you, BetterHelp, for sponsoring this video. Is there something preventing you from your happiness and preventing you from achieving your goals? BetterHelp assesses your needs and matches you with your own licensed professional. You can start communicating with them within 48 hours if you're in dire need to talk to someone. It is not a crisis line. It is not a self-help line. It is professional counseling. There is a large range of expertise in BetterHelp's counseling network. This service is available worldwide, and you can log into your account anytime to message your therapist. Whenever, however, you will have access to your therapist. You will receive timely and thoughtful responses. Also, you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions. BetterHelp is committed to facilitating great therapeutic matches, so they make it easy and free to change counselors. It is definitely way more affordable than traditional counseling. As I've done, it's $500 to $700 an hour. But with BetterHelp, it is completely affordable and they have financial aid available. I cannot stress how important it is to get your mental health right. BetterHelp wants you to start living a happier life today. Visit betterhelp.com/Harush. That's better, HELP.com. And join over the 1 million people that are already taking charge of their mental health. If any of you guys are interested and are even thinking about it, if you are thinking about getting mental help, this is your sign. Like, this is the sign that you do it. My followers are going to receive 10% off at betterhelp.com/Harush. If any of you guys, again, like, this is like for real, serious, all bullshit aside, if you guys are considering getting mental help, and do not be embarrassed by it, do not get shunned. I know in some cultures it's like unheard of. You have to suck it up and move on. This is your sign to do so. It is extremely affordable. Again, financial aid is available. This starts at $60. Again, if you go into a traditional therapist office or a psychologist or psychiatrist office, it's going to range from $500 to $700 an hour. And not everyone can afford that. So if you guys are in need of this, go ahead and check it out. And don't forget, betterhelp.com/Harush. So my makeup on this trip, I really thought I was gonna do a lot of liquids and I ended up contradicting myself. Even though I did do everything liquid, I realized quickly with the sun and the wind combined, it was a lot of streaks on my face because my hair was like all over my face. Thank God I took some powders with me. This is how I did my makeup the entire vacation, just because I really didn't feel like sitting there for an hour and glamming. I wanted to have fun with my friends. I was there to have fun, and it was kind of like a reunion moment. We're celebrating life, love. It was just, I didn't want to like take too much time getting ready, if you get what I mean. And I know I was serving a lot of looks, but I actually did all those looks within 20 minutes. So without further ado, let me get to show you how you can turn yourself out within 20 minutes. You can time me, I guess, but like, you know, I'm opening up products and stuff. The key to getting your makeup done very, very fast is your tools. And I think a lot of people think like it's product. Sometimes it's product, yes, but tools. What's going to make it easier for you to do everything? You need to make sure your skin is correctly prepped. I've talked to you guys about this. Some of you guys still choose not to prep your skin correctly. This is the Tula Balancing Act. It's a pH balance and created with probiotics and superfoods toner. And I have been living for this. Why is it important to have on toner? Because it brings out the color back into your face. As you guys can see how it just got red, cleans your face, no matter how clean you think your face is, unless you hit it with a toner, you will not know for sure. And it just removes all the excess that doesn't need to be there. The stuff that makes your makeup crack or your face get oily, whatever it may be, toner gets rid of it. And I always do my neck as well, darling. Don't count my skin prep, because you have to let the toner sit. You cannot apply a moisturizer immediately after toner. It will burn your skin. You have to let the toner sit for a moment. See how it already made my skin glowy woey? I've told you guys about this many, 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 many times. I use a night cream as the base of my makeup. This is again from the same brand, Tula. I have discovered this the past couple months and I'm obsessed. It doesn't smell good, I'm letting you guys know. It's not like one of those like pleasant scents that you put on your skin. But again, it's made with probiotics and superfoods and I love how it holds my makeup and it works amazing as a night cream. So if you guys are on a budget, honey, this is the jam. So you're gonna massage upward motions like that. Let's get the neck underneath my eyes, around my nose, that lymphatic massage. This really helps to tighten out your face on the long run. And then don't forget your eyelids. This under eye balm, you guys, check it out. That side's on, right? I'm gonna massage it for you on screen. I usually don't like eye creams because I feel like they're very similar. You can just do a moisturizer instead of an eye cream, but this balm is next level. So the next thing I'm going to do is pick up on the night cream again. Remember, I like mixing night cream with the RCMAs. Why I love RCMA so much, till God do us part, is because it just gets the job done so fast. And honestly, the way it photographs and looks on camera and in person is beautiful. RCMA is a professional makeup foundation and it's very, very, very affordable. I'm gonna use Shinto 2 and I rubbed some of the night cream and I'm gonna use one of these hairbrush brushes. I've linked these a lot. And again, you guys, if you want anything, it's in my description, you can click on it. So I wanna show you guys how easy, look at this, pick up on some night cream. The secret of this foundation is if you don't pick up on night cream and do this, it's not gonna be so smooth. It's gonna be a little thick, you know? This is good for dry skin, oily skin, all skin types, this foundation. And it's buildable, so let's say I wanna go in more. Now I'll skip the night cream. Look at the difference, you can make it more opaque. This is with night cream only, this is no night cream, and you just buff it in. Another cool factor of this foundation, you do not need to set it. I'm just doing my lids. I'm just using a synthetic blending brush. This is like the quintessential makeup look. because I wore this on the boat, I wore this by the pool, and this is the skin I did for the wedding. I just did more eye. Let me tell you, it photographed real nice. I was very happy with it. Cleaning up the lip. Comment down below if you guys take a long time getting ready on vacation. I feel like every single time I say I'm gonna turn out looks and this and that, I actually end up not caring and just wanting to hang out with everyone. So this is my personal KKW number one color corrector, and I am just going to lay where it belongs. Right there, right there, right there. I like to do it right there, I don't know why. So then I was really bold with the Chart Shape Tape in Light. I just put like literally the tiniest bit. This is very different than my regular routine that I do. Like literally, I just put a tiny bit and a little bit right there. Center down the bridge of my nose. I am going to grab a synthetic brush and I'm just going to place it where I want it to dry. Sides of my nose, up, creating a cat eye effect. This is an instant eye lift. Why I chose to do this video is because honestly, depression rates are so high and recently I've been there and I understand it. And I find it really messed up that if you don't have health insurance, it's going to be very difficult for you to get help because truly it's very expensive. Some of my sessions were like $500, $700 per hour. So I can't even imagine like somebody that is struggling how they're gonna pay for it. It's not fair. Like what are they supposed to do, suffer? Two lines over here, you're gonna pull up like that. And I'm just using the residue, you guys. I'm gonna use the Radiant Creamy Concealer for NARS. I've used this on clients, never on myself. I just found it so easy to use. If you're in a rush, you don't even need a brush. Oh, I made a rhyme.
If you're in a rush, you don't need a brush. If you're in a rush, you don't need a brush.
I'm gonna contour around the highlighted area on the Cupid's bow. We all know I'm obsessed. Why? So obsessed with me. I just think that this trip reminded me how much I miss community, how much I missed my friends that I get to work with, my colleagues, and how much they inspire me. We all were talking about it, like, we need to do this more often. You're gonna make just a line like that. It's literally a straight line. We gonna dip dip some mo, line like that for the contour underneath the jaw. I'm going to take a little bit of the Kylie stick for contour, mix it up on the brush, just very lightly. I'm gonna hit the forehead. I know this is really weird. I don't know how I came up with this concept. I do the forehead really fast before I spray this. So it's the Mist and Fix. It is the Makeup Forever Mist and Fix. Gets the face nice and dewy. Now I'll go back in to the forehead. It was make this very interesting face. I just really like this color, like the color it gives. Cool trick if you keep doing this down, makes your neck look thinner. Ooh, I'm with the left hand. Look, Ma, both hands. I'm just gonna use a clean Real Techniques brush. Pull that concealer. Y'all see how that got real gooey and dewy real fast. And that was Chart Shape Tape. That shit does not get gooey. I'm gonna tap it in. Tap, tap, tap in.
Tap, tap, tap in. Diamonds, that's not.
Now with the residue of this, I'm just gonna like blend down. You get a damp booty blender. We're gonna take the Real Techniques brush really fast. Blend the eye out. You can use any radiant foundation. I'm gonna use the Chanel Vita Lumiere in the shade 50. I'm gonna grab it on the back of the sponge and I'm gonna hit it right in between the contour and the highlight. It creates the in-between shade. And then you just beat that shit in. And then now with the residue, I'll pack it in everywhere else. If you guys are suffering with a problem or need anyone to talk to, please comment down below. I'm going to be responding to a lot of comments on this video. Gonna be praying for some of you. Like, some of you guys personally message me and are going through so much hardships. And I feel for you. My heart genuinely goes out to a lot of people. This panoramic has really caused a lot of sadness for a lot of people, including me. I am introverted, but I need to get out and like let loose a little bit. So with the residue of this, we are just literally tap. You're not taking it back and forth. You're just tapping, just like that. Under eye one more time. Now, if you guys like a dewy look, you can literally just like set right here and keep it at that. But as I quickly realized while I was there, nah, dog, you need a little bit more, even though I tried to do it all. But this is Patrick Star, his Turn Up the Base powder. Came in quite handy, to be honest. So I'm gonna take one of the Rihanna brushes, peck, peck, peck in underneath my eye. And I know you guys are probably thinking like, you just took away the brightness, but give me a second. I'll show you guys. Around my mouth, I do need on my forehead, picking up on a kabuki like brush. You guys, just to let you know, with this powder, you actually don't need to put on foundation. I'm just a little loony and it's 4 times blended. Oh, and excuse my hands, I got really, really burnt. We're gonna go in with the medium dark 4G. Basically use it as like a contour shade, bringing color back into the face. I love this tone because it's like golden. Definitely gives you that vacation tone. I'm gonna go in with Suede from Kat Von D using this Real Techniques brush, which is like a gray tone. Look at how easy that is. Just, and if you guys don't wanna do the liquid contour, you can just do it with this and you'll be fine. One size translucent. I've really been liking it. Bright as hell. So we toned it down and then we're gonna give some brightness. And you guys know that I love mixing powders. This is one of the first translucents I've seen that I don't have to mix it, which is speaks all like volumes. And I am just going to place it right there and let it sit. Now, the reason why I like putting on pressed powder before translucent, I just feel like your skin comes out a lot more smoother. I've been doing this for a very long time. I think the way I discovered it was super accidental when I skipped a step. That's the cool thing about being in a rush when you're doing makeup. You get to discover weird techniques. On my chin. And again, you guys could have just done the moisturizer and then used just the powders. You could have skipped the foundation step if you wanted to, but I don't know, for me, I just feel like I wanted that lockdown because especially on vacation, that shit was coming off. So it's like, what was the point of wearing it then? Center of the nose. I'm gonna grab this chisel brush, mix them up, dust it off, just like that. I'm telling you, tools make everything easy. Pat it in right there. I'm gonna go in with the Natasha Denona blush in Blush Duo number 2, Golden Coral. Picking up on the blush, smile. I'm gonna tap in actually a little bit underneath my eye right there. And the reason why I like this blush a lot, it like has a highlighter in there too. Makes it really easy and I just love the color. So I'm gonna grab an eyeshadow brush and yes, I'm putting blush on my eyes and pulling it out. Very pretty color. It looks like you're giving the most. And then with a Jaclyn Hill Morphe JH30 brush, I'm gonna go in to that medium dark 4 golden. And I'm just going to pack it in like that, pull out and make it make sense with it. With the small brush, I'm gonna go right underneath with that same foundation color on the sides of the nose, around the lip a little bit. Now using a Real Hair brush, it's a slant brush. I'm gonna go into just a chocolate color. I am going to make an eyeliner effect. If there's fallout, we still haven't wiped down the translucent, so it's fine. Don't freak out. And you're gonna mimic what an eyeliner would be with a shadow, but not with the black, with the brown. This is the best way to get that cat eye effect without it being too aggressive, especially in the sun. I feel like the liquid eyeliners look a little cray-cray, unless they're perfectly done. I'm gonna pick up on a little bit of black, just a tiny bit, and pack it in. You can skip the step, you don't have to do it. I just like to pack it in on my lash line. I'm gonna do my lip really fast. I'm picking up on Sorme, it's called Baby Doll. Revlon, you guys already know this color. If you wanna know what it is, click the link down below. This is like my go-to lip combo. It's like bullshit free. So then now we are going to clean all of the translucent powder by pushing it up by my nose, wiping it away a little bit. So when you put on the blush and the contour shade before you put on the translucent will blend it for you. It's kind of crazy. Around my cheek, I'm just going to press it in because that ate it up. Now I'm going to use just a clean powder puff. I'm just gonna press in all the highlighted areas first. Look at the difference. And this helps get rid of all the excess, and it pushes in, like it stamps your makeup. And then go into the rest of your face. If you're not good at blending powders, this is your whole solution. I'm going to use Marc Jacobs eyeshadow in Omega Shadow, Perfect 01500, down the bridge of my nose, inner corner. And it helps when you do the inner corner from the top, just to let you guys know. Cupid's bow. And then we are gonna go in with the highlight in this palette. As you guys can tell, it's one of my favorite cheek combos, just right there. Look at how fast that was. Okay, I'm just gonna use this Lancome Idole. I don't know if you guys have tried this, but it's really, 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 really good. I tried out that Sky High mascara everyone was talking about. Bitch, I had issues getting it off. So no thank you. Not trying to go blind over here. And I got lash extensions by Lashes Diana. I think for vacation, lash extensions is a game changer. All I had to do was put on half lashes, which I get like wispies and I just cut them in half using duo glue. You're gonna let that get tacky for a second. While I do that, I'm just gonna brush up my brows using the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. My brows were very much the vibe the whole trip. And you guys check this, I didn't wear tapes the entire time. That means I didn't care at all. Before we continue and put on the lashes, I really, really love this spray because you see how much powder I put on. This, you have to shake it really, really well. Makes it look like you have nothing on. It like really, I don't know what specs it puts in your face. Makes your face look wet for a second. Probably spray it on my arms too. Sprays it on everything, including Alaya. Get a synthetic brush, move it around. Gonna grab the half lash. My eye is going to stay open and I'm gonna look straight. You can look down to know where you're gonna hit it. Lightly open your eye. With half lashes, you always wanna tilt the edge where it's like sitting on your skin, and then the inner corner is where your lash line is, because that way you're creating a full effect where your eye goes higher. Does that make sense? And then again on your skin, lift it up. And the shadow that we placed there will hide the skin. This technique is really, really amazing for people that have droopy eyes or puppy dog eyes, as some people like to call it. That was it, my darlings. This was literally my glam on the whole trip for anyone that was asking, anyone that wanted to know. I feel like I went in expecting to only do liquids and I got played very, 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 very fast. And this just made everything super fast for me, so I get to go and enjoy my time with my friends. If you guys don't take time to communicate with other people around you currently, please do. The isolation that we've endured the past year is not normal and it is not healthy for our mental health. The reason why I chose to do this video is because not only me, I have been affected by this, but so many people that I talk to, my friends, family, everyone is just in like depression mode a little bit. And this trip was such a pick-me-up for me. I just got so inspired. I was living my best life once again. And please, you guys, I don't want to see anything in the comments of COVID, COVID. We were extremely careful. Everyone kept getting tested over and over again. It was us in the resort. So we were a group of us. We were extremely safe. We went out there to celebrate Shayla and Les, celebrate one of the greatest loves I've ever seen. And it was amazing. It was beautiful. Once again, thank you BetterHelp for sponsoring this video. I actually wanted to work with them because a lot of you guys have messaged me so many stories, whether it's been you're emailing me, DMing me, or commenting. And I really thought that this would be a great way for some of you guys to get help and to seek healing and to move forward. On that note, I hope you guys like the makeup, my vacation beat. I hope you guys loved the vlog. I tried, it's like a baby little vlog. And I'm gonna leave you guys with this quote: keep doing what you're doing. We're all being judged by someone who's not even close to having their shit together, which is facts on facts on facts. Everyone wants to judge everyone, but everyone should just go look at themselves in the mirror first and get their shit together. Busy people don't stay judging other people. They keep it moving and they stay in their lane and they move forward, and that's why they're successful. People that are just unhappy should visit BetterHelp. Definitely should stop judging others, because when you judge somebody else, it's usually something that's inside of you that you either want to excel or you don't like. So again, you don't walk in somebody else's shoes. So leave the judgment for the birds. And even in every single holy book, it says judgment is one of the greatest sins. I love you guys. Thank you so, so much for watching. Once again, I cannot thank you guys enough for allowing me to have this platform to be able to do this and have fun with you guys every single week on Sundays. Love you. Goodbye.